Bag of things, they have to make a statement. If I know bag of things, TV, it no make sense. A bag of things, TV, I run things all the time. Bag of things, they have to make a statement. If I know bag of things, TV, it no make sense. A bag of things, TV, I run things all the time.
Yes, I, Elmatic, there's a represent for bag of things, TV media. You don't know, tune in, you hear a bag of things.
Bag of things, TV media.
Up top, baga 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 things media TV, viewers and subscribers, missing Clarendon teachers, body found in Sandy B, Chano Star, and we never did want this, viewers and sub, me nah lie, the worst confirm right now, the worst thing happened to Jamaica, you know, yes me I say, this lady has been missing for a couple of days now, and we were hoping for the best, but right now Star, the sad news came out. Natalie Dawkins is not here with us anymore, ladies and gentlemen. Hear what I'm saying, my people, now, reading from the loop. Natalie Dawkins, the Clarendon teacher who has been missing for over a week, has been found dead. Police have confirmed that her body was found in a shallow grave in Sandy Bay, Clarendon, on Tuesday. Dawkins, a teacher of four parts, primary and junior high school, has been missing since Tuesday, March the 30th, ladies and gentlemen. The educator's motor vehicle was found in a Bellas Gate, St. Catherine, on Saturday, April the 3rd, after two men attempted to sell it. The men engaged police in a shootout and one was subsequently killed while the other escaped. The deceased man has since been identified as 20-year-old Jeff Bedwards, alias Waterlord of Bellas Gate, St. Catherine and Chateau and Sandy Bay District in Clarendon. Viewers and subscribers, wicked boy Star, wicked dirty little boy them, you know, murder the lady, try to take away her car and sell the car. You understand? And right now, her body is found, Star. Really sad. The paper goes on to say, Bedward's brother was taken into custody on Wednesday as probe into her disappearance continued. Viewers and subscribers. Now, here we are going again. During a radio interview on Wednesday, head of the Corporate Communication Unit, CCU, Senior Superintendent Stephanie Lindsay said the police are making checks if anyone who turned up at a medical facility with gunshots could be the man who was shot and injured during the confrontation with police in Bellas Gate, St. Catherine on the weekend. Viewers and subscribers, be things are going, crocus bugger things are going in a jam dung Star, Jano Star, the worst has been confirmed right now. Viewers and sub, the lady is gone, Star. Jano, condolences to the family, you know. And now catch your levers now. In addition, the forensic tests are underway on the teacher's vehicle. The Four Paws police reported that Dawkins, 44, was last seen at her home in Denby, Clarendon on Tuesday, March the 30th, at about 11:30 a.m. when she was contacted by her neighbor about her car alarm that kept going off. Viewers and sub, at the last time the people them see her, you know, the last goddamn time they see the woman, and with the alarm go off and the neighbor reach out to her. You see me, I say, all right, here we are going again. The following morning, her relatives tried to contact her, but their calls went unanswered. Relatives visited the teacher's home and realized that her car and other items was missing. At that the time, a little dirty boy and TV woman care gone with her and bag of foolishness, you know. And here we are going. While making checks, they were informed by the Spanish Town Police that Dawkins' handbag was found on Highway 2000 along the Spanish Town leg, you know. The dirty little boy, them. Me telling about the little boy in Jamaica, you know. I be a badness and take up, be a foolish number go on with. Then kill the lady and fling with her bag. Show with the woman bag by Highway 2000. And I try and make them escape. That's why I'm glad the police wet up one of them. And one of them upon the run right now. But him not go live. Him not go live long. Cause where more run go? Which part more run go? At that more annoying. This is how Jamaica fi set up that criminal boys can't get away. Criminal clowns. And I don't want the criminal sympathizer them. They are about them, you know. Alright. You are going, you know. Subscribe to your channel. Touch up notification bell. Like up a video. See you where you don't know. A bag of things. Media TV. And right now, the big top police them are theorize that this person, this lady, might have get killed because she was a bailiff, you know. Here where the big man has said, Francita, now. Cops are in possible link between teacher's fate and role as a bailiff. So you must say, basically, maybe she get killed because she was a bailiff. She was carrying out certain job. I want to know a bailiff thing go already. Where bailiff though? Bailiff come and seize possession. Things where people buy are them pay down pan and care and finish pay fee. The bailiff then come and take it. You understand? So they must say, boy, the cops, they must say, maybe that are the reason they must terrorize. They must put one and two together, you know. At that they might do. You know what I'm saying? They might put one and two together because a big investigation in other case. Yeah. Viewers and subscribers. I'm not telling you what I go on. They must say still. Deputy Commissioner of Police Fitz Bailey, you know. Here with Mr. Fitz Bailey, I say no. Police investigators are exploring the possibility that the grisly disappearance and possible death of Clarendon teacher Natalie Dawkins could have been linked to her part-time job as a bailiff. When the sister analyze me, I tell. Right, now the paper goes on to say the disclosure was made by Deputy Commissioner of Police, DCP, in charge of crime, Fitz Bailey, following the discovery of a body believed to be that of Dawkins in a shallow grave in Sandy Bay, Clarendon, on Thursday. In quotation, here we must say now, we are also looking at the theory. Was she taken away because of her work as a bailiff? Did she do something to someone in terms of maybe the possibility of seizing goods?
And someone was aggrieved by that and maybe got at her, stated Bailey.
Those are some good possibilities the man put out there, you know. A reality, you know. When you do them job, you get exposed to a whole heap of danger. Just like the policeman, when the policeman arrests somebody, the policeman exposes himself to be killed. Army personnel to security guard. All of these high profile jobs, these jobs expose you to violence, viewers and subscribers. So, me really think say maybe that caused the whole thing, you know. It could be. You understand? So, right now, RIP to the family, condolences. You know what I mean? Me really sad for this incident and the turnout. I was expecting the best. You don't know, say Bagatins Media TV, hopeful and optimistic. The Jamaican people, them hopeful too. But every time the people, them gone missing, are the worst thing ever happened to we. We always have to get this type of result. You know what I'm saying? But right now, we need this for change. I can't wait till this pass. Jamaica go through a dark phase right now. Me not lie. But we have to band together, you know. We have to work together. The police, them work effectively. The citizens, them work effectively. But the government needs to step up and spend more damn money. And that's my problem. You understand? I mean, not stop bash them and beat them because they can do better. Notice how they jump up and take woolly stance when it comes to COVID-19. But they not spend a sufficient amount of money for dealing with crime in Jamaica. We have a social problem. This is why them look a young youth want thief people care, kill people and rob them and do all type of stuff. Social problem, Mr. Government, Mr. Prime Minister. You know what I'm saying? I want you guys to understand how I go on. All right, you know, me now, me not lie, you know. The problem in Jamaica not hard to fix, you know. The problem in Jamaica is not hard to fix. It is simple. Just fix the social problem. We have social decays. The youth in Jamaica will run around, give them something to do. These little young boys need jobs. They need skills. They need something to take their mind off of violence, crime and violence, ladies and gentlemen. It is so simple. The first world country, them do it. Why we can't do it as a little small island? And Jamaica is so small. We can easily get it done, viewers and sub. We don't follow about the things made at TV, man. A mad thing. Now, here we are going and now. A crazy thing going on in Portmore, you know. We don't notice how Portmore get warm from what here. As some criminal boys and criminal clowns are making way in Portmore. And I live there. And I run off a place. And I go on with bag of foolishness over there. But here we are going and now. Waterford area done killed in gun attack at Portmore Center. Portmore Town Center, you know. You understand? Finally.
Right now, every dad in Jamaica must get dirt.
You know what I'm saying? Me no want nobody a walk around about them a dan there. All the dad must left back in Jamaica, Clarendon. You know what I'm saying? Me no sorry for none of them. Here we go on. Two men were shot and injured by unknown assailant during a daylight gun attack at about 2 p.m. at the Portmore Town Center located on Passage Fort Drive. In Portmore, viewers and subscribers. The attacker subsequently fled the scene on a motorbike Me know say a yeng yeng that, you know. Yes, man. A straight up yeng yeng, I wait for him right there, someone. I wait for attackers, them.
Again, one understand? Of the victims,
a well-known underworld figure from Man Earth Road, era of Waterford in Portmore, who is called V-I-C-H, died as a result of the attack. V-I-C-H, how you guys pronounce that? I pronounce it Vish. You know what I'm saying? Some people might say Vic or Vish. You know what I'm saying? But right now, they must say, boy, I get slapped with. You understand? Boy, I really feel it for any innocent people in the vicinity where get hurt and everything. But anybody will call themselves Dan, and of them around place, me not no sympathy for them. You understand? Yeah, man. Go and clean up Jamaica from all Dan. Dan have one and all of them Bombay there. Get them out of Jamaica right now. Everybody in Jamaica must be normal citizen. I go out and work and I pay their light bill. And I pay them bill and I do all type of good things in the community. We don't want no more Dan in a place I walk up and down in a desert clocks. And I roll out weed in a, and I go on like them can't tell people what to do. None of that again. Different time we are dealing with right now. You see and I want to add that the man that will respond for the murderation I must get caught by the police. Because I know for them job this. But at the same time, criminal clones have to take out other criminal clones. We make it job easy for the police them. I just saw a thing go. You understand? Hear what I must say again. The police confirmed that the attack, but have so far been unable to identify the victims. You know what I'm saying? So that I go all right and now viewers and subscribers. A bag of things media TV, man. Up and running. Like and share and subscribe. Bang, 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 bang.
Bag of things media TV, man. Thank you for watching. Make sure you share it. Make sure you subscribe. Press that notification bell to stay updated, man. Jamaican assassin killing all names. Urban legend. Jackal. Out.
Got the sauce.